Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about the function prototype. What is function prototype is the declaring the function. Okay, so here when you say a function is present in the particular program, you have to say declare the function is present. So in order to say the function is present, we have to give this syntax. Okay, in programming, a declaration of the function to the compiler indicating what types of parameters are passed to it and what value is returned. So we know that how you write a function in return type, function name, and then the parameter list. So every parameter should have its type. So here type 1 argument 1, type 2 argument 2, and so on, and this should end with the semicolon. This is called as a function prototype. So what is the function of this function prototype? By this the compiler is indicated that a function is present by this name, and then it has the arguments of this type, and the function will return the return type whatever is mentioned over here. And the compiler can then report an error if a function within the program is not returned to conform to the prototype. Suppose when you are calling the function or when you are using the function, this particular prototype is not matched. For example, instead of int you are giving, you are calling by float, or we are declaring char, you are calling by string. So if any mismatch in the type or the number of arguments is the type of arguments or the return type, any mismatch occurs, then the compiler will say that this is an error. Okay, when we get the syntax error in the other statement, same way when the function prototype is not matched with the function call or function definition, the system will consider this as an error. Okay, so that is the, so by this the compiler is told what is the pattern of the function and what are all the types of the arguments and the return type. Okay, so now here it is shown as a Pythagorean representation, function prototype. So here you can see here, so this is the int, this is the function return type, and then heading is the function name, and then void is a return type. Here this function has no parameters. Okay, and then when you are writing the function, actually this is the, when you are writing the function as a function definition, that time there should not be a semicolon. That means we are going to start the function. In the previous, this is actually a prototype declaration where should end with a semicolon, but when you start the function definition, it should start with, this is the header of the function, which is the function prototype, and then after that the function starts with the open brace and all the returns, all the statements of the function, and finally the return statement from the function, and then the close brackets. So this is the whole function body. Okay, so now here, what is the purpose of the function prototype? Why should they have the function prototype? Some purposes are mentioned here. It tells the return type of the data that the function will return. It tells the number of arguments passed to the function. It tells the data types of each of the passed arguments. Also, it tells the order in which the arguments are passed to the function. So here, these three points you have seen earlier, and next fourth point what is included is the order in which the arguments are passed. For example, when you are calling this function, and I am calling this int and then char, but while calling it, we are calling by char and int, that is also a mistake. So the order is also important. Okay, so how we are defining the function, how we declare the function, the same way you have to call the function also. The parameter type and order also should not match. What is the order? The arrangement of, that means then the order in which the arguments are typed inside the function bracket is the order of the arguments. Okay, so that also should match with the function arguments. Okay, so these are all the purpose the function prototype is meant for. And then why we need the function as a user, why we need the function? The functions are used because of the following reason: to improve the readability of the code. As I told you, yeah, when you are having a lengthy program, we have also seen the example of atom number program. It is a lengthy program where you have different functions like square was there, and then reverse digit is there, and then check atom number is there. So there are three different functions are there. Okay, and again in the case of NPR, NCR also, we have factorial function is there, NPR function is there, and NCR function is there. So what is the purpose of the functions is, it improves the readability of the code. That means we are making the code readable by using the, like a module type. For example, this is similar to when you are writing a big essay, we always go by paragraphs and paragraphs. We start the introduction, then go to the next para, write something about the one para, and then go to the next para. And then so if each para will contain some 5 to 6 lines and has different meaning. Likewise, when you are writing a lengthy program, we are supposed to use this, the usage of function is very comfortable. So that is called as a modularity of the function. Okay, that means the function can be make the readability of the function. And what is reusability is the same function can be called by different programs also. Once you write a function and that function is inside one program, if you write the function as a global function, then other program also can use the function. That is called as a reusability of the code. Okay, and then debugging of the code would be easier if you use the functions, as errors are easy to be traced. For example, when you are getting some error in the program, after compilation we can find out where the error is. The error is in the main program, the error is in the function, which function. So this when you are debugging, the debugging will be easier when you are writing the program as a function type. And also it reduces the size of the code in we are reducing the duplicate set of statements are reduced. Okay, so that means here the size of the code is also reduced. Why? Because instead of repeatedly writing the same function again and again, we can use the repeated set of instructions in order to make the function in the reduced size. That means you can reduce the number of codes in the statements instead of writing unnecessarily again and again the same statement again. Because for example, in the factorial program, so once you call the function factorial function, the function will call and get the values. No need to write every time the factorial function again and again. So this will reduce the size of the code. Okay, and then these are all the ways by which the function helps to achieve the modularity and reusability, so that the user, when you are writing large programs, it will be very reader friendly, and so that the user can also find out the errors and make the code also reusable for the other programs. Hope you understood the basic concept of functions, and thanks for watching.